So we're standing here in the, you know, about a year later after the shingle fire. And as you can see around me, there's a lot of aspen sprouts, aspen sprouting here. And aspen is a disturbance dependent species. So without disturbance such as this fire, the aspen around here are gonna get older, get a little bit bigger, get shaded out by the conifers that come in, and then they're gonna die and kind of go away. Because when you have disturbance, it opens the ground up, lets the aspen shoots come up from the roots, the sun hits the ground, hits the aspen, and allows them to grow. So, you know, from the ashes of the shingle fire, we have this aspen sprouting up, and this is gonna be a nice little aspen patch in a few years. So before the shingle fire burned through here, you know, there was no aspen sprouting. All the young aspen sprouts are getting shaded out and dying. After the fire comes through, a lot of aspen sprouting. This is actually a very important food source for ungulates like elk and deer. You can see on this particular plant that they've eaten the tops off of these, and good stuff, good food for those animals in the spring and fall. And you know, aspen is a real telltale of forest health. Forests need disturbance, especially these ponderosa pine and aspen forests that we have here. And as our aspen has been going away due to lack of disturbance, that really says something about the health of our forest. When you have a fire like this come in, introduces that disturbance, aspen has a chance to come back and introduce that diversity that forests need to be healthy. So due to a lack of disturbance in the West, we've lost about 2/3 of our aspen, and aspen are continuing to decline. You know, it is nice to see places like this where aspen actually has a chance to grow and prosper.